Hey, Corrine. Any progress?
Nope.
They are all convinced that the magic core must die.
That's one hard-headed family.
I guess I might agree with them too, if I were an outsider.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, that's okay. I've got something to discuss with you, actually.
What now?
The ascetic monk just paid me a visit and...
So, simply put, just absorbing the golem with your right arm isn't enough to save the person inside?
We sure lucked out with you then, Corrine.
That's no laughing matter! I was almost... hollowed out!
Yeah. The Lord of Earth's magic core was like an empty shell.
It's frightening to think I almost ended up like that.
But you didn't, so stop thinking about it.
I'm afraid we have to think about it, for Toya's sake. What can we do? It might not go so well next time.
We need to talk to someone who knows about these things.
But the ascetic monk doesn't know anything. I can't see regular folk being too up on this stuff either.
Regular folk, indeed.
Rygar, do you have any idea?
Not really. Not at all, in fact.
Hey, Rygar, that reminds me. Didn't you once go to the Sage's Tower?
Did I?
Yes, I'm sure you told me you did.
The Sage's Tower?
Some wise woman who's supposed to be centuries old lives in that tower.
Hey, Rygar, it sounds like you know just the old crone we need to meet.
Yeah. Take us to her!
I don't think...
What? Some kind of problem?
It might be considered a problem. She isn't the sort to just give anyone an audience.
Yeah, right. Come on, let's go. Rygar, take us there.
What I'm trying to say is...
You dispute the word of your princess?
Very well. I will lead you there. The Sage's Tower lies to the north of the desert, across the volcanic path. But I don't know if she will see us or...
North of the desert, across the volcanic path. Let's go then.
As you say.
As you say.
As you say.
here we go.
Shudder.
Thank you.
Let's go!
Don't let your guard down! Hold on!
Before a fall. Thank you.
healing.
Water!
Here we go!
Yeah. What a pity!
Thank you.
with everything. Here we go.
Yeah.
Water!
Unfortunately, it is.
What do you mean, unfortunately? Is this sage that unpleasant?
No, she's almost too nice.
Okay, ignore Rygar, and off we go!
Yeah!
I knew you'd come.
What?
Atsuma, you plan on going to the sage's tower?
Oh, you again! Yeah, I'm gonna find a way to save Toya at the sage's tower.
Pointless.
What?
I'm telling you, it's pointless. I have been to see the sage. I've done everything possible. There's no way to save Toya.
But I'm not giving up. There may be a way to save him, just like there was with Kareen.
Well, that might be true. But finding a way to save him, that is not the problem.
Why not?
Because Toya himself doesn't want to be saved. So, you cannot save him.
You're lying! How can you know that?
Because I talked with him.
What?
Do you know what Toya said? He called you a total pain, a total nuisance.
You're lying!
Toya is with the Queen of Ice because he wants to be.
That's a lie! A lie!
Toya is attempting to cast off his limitations as a mortal. Toya, that fool, is planning on becoming one with the Queen of Ice.
Becoming one?
Yes. By choosing to become part of the actual Devil Golem, he can transcend mortal bounds. That is what Toya wants.
You're joking! I'm not gonna believe anything you say!
You refuse to believe Toya himself.
What?
Remember everything Toya has said to you up to this point.
But that was because Toya was being controlled.
What proof do you have that he's being controlled?
But...
you are just twisting the truth to suit what you want to believe. Saving Toya from the Queen of Ice no longer means releasing him from her clutches. The only way to save him now is to kill him.
That's not for you to decide!
And you can make that decision, can you? On behalf of everyone in the world? Think on that. Farewell.
Damn!
Atsuma.
I'm not paying attention to anything he says! We can't afford to waste any more time here.